continue with the breathing. And as you're breathing, we want to focus on the Ujjayi breath in the back of our throat. So we will continue to breathe, but close your lips and hear that ocean sound. Last one, inhale. And then exhale. Slowly move your way into tabletop position on all fours. And when you're in tabletop position, we want to have pressure on our fingertips and also on our palms. Inhale, cat, open your heart. And then exhale, round your back and feel your spine elongate to the ceiling. Inhale. And then exhale. Inhale. And then exhale. Inhale, open up your right arm to the sky. And then exhale, thread it through and between your left hand and your left knee. Feel the stretch from your shoulder to your elbow and extend your left hand to the sky. Or you can place it in behind the crease between your right quad and your hip flexor. Inhale, exhale, slowly shift your way back. Place your left hand on the ground and your right hand on the ground. And then lift your left hand to the sky. Open your heart. And then exhale, thread it through. Into your right hand and your right knee. Inhale your right hand to the sky. Feel that stretch on your left arm. And then you can bring your right hand behind in that crease. Inhale, right arm up to the sky. Exhale, slowly put it down to the ground, back into tabletop. And we're going to flip our toes and go back into downward facing dog. Walk it out. Feel that stretch from your Achilles all the way up your calves into your hamstrings, which are also right behind your knees. Continue to walk it out, and then find stillness in your downward facing dog. We're going to do two breaths here. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, and then exhale. And then we're going to shift our way, roll like the wave, into plank position. And then exhale, chaturanga, slowly. Make sure your elbows are squeezed towards your core, and then inhale, upward facing dog, gently. Maybe you might go into cobra first. And then exhale, flip your feet into downward facing dog. And then roll forward like the wave one more time into your plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Elbows squeeze towards your core, and then flip your toes. Upward facing dog, or cobra, and downward facing dog. Gently walk, step, or float to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Grab your elbows. Walk back and forth with your knees. Relax your body. Feel all the blood rush to your head. And then release your arms and around into the sky. And then down through heart center, find stillness. Maybe tilt your hips forward so that you're engaging your core in mountain pose. And then exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift. Continue to breathe. Place your hands on the ground. Step back into plank.
chaturanga,
upward facing dog,
find your flow. Two more of these. Jump, step your foot to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Round your hands to the sky. Down with your heart center. Find one thing you're thankful for. And exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale, place your hands to the ground. Step back into plank, chaturanga. Exhale. Inhale, upward facing dog. Flip your toes down, facing dog. And then one more time. Inhale, jump, step, or foot to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, round your hands to the sky. Down through heart center. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Jump back into chaturanga. Make sure your elbows are squeezed towards your core. Inhale. Upward facing dog, and then find yourself into downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg to the sky. Fan open your right hip. Good, feel that stretch, bend that leg, and then find yourself in one-legged downward facing dog. Roll your body forward in a wave into plank and bring that right knee to your right elbow, left elbow, and then step with your right foot in between your two hands into crescent lunge. And then flip, turn that back foot into warrior one, 45 degrees, and then exhale, warrior two. Tilt your hips forward. Inhale, reach forward. And then shift back into reverse warrior. And then back into warrior two. Straighten your front leg. Inhale, reach as far as you can. Exhale. Right hand either to the ground or to the ankle. And reach your left hand up, still engaging your core. And then turn, face your right leg, place your hands in between your feet, and then bring your right leg back into plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Upward facing dog, flip your feet. Downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left leg to the sky. Fan open that leg. And then shift forward into plank, bringing that left knee to your elbow, left knee to your right elbow, and then forward in between your feet. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, turn that back foot 45 degrees. Shift your hips forward, warrior two. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, reverse warrior. Inhale, back into warrior two. Straighten that front leg, shift forward. And then bring that right hand down to the ground or to your left ankle. And then feel your body elongate. Like there's a string from your finger, your pointer finger and your thumb down to the ground. Exhale, hands between your, besides your feet, bring your left foot back into plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Inhale, walk, step, or foot to the top of your mat. Exhale, halfway lift. Inhale, forward fold. Exhale, round your hands to the sky, down through heart center. Place your hands on the ground, jump back into chaturanga. Upward facing dog, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg to the sky. Fan open for a second. Let's stretch. And then shift into bringing your right leg in between your feet, up into crescent lunge, warrior one, 45 degrees with your back foot, warrior two, shift forward, reverse warrior, and then exhale, straighten your front leg, shift forward again, place
Place your right hand to the ground or to your right ankle. Elongate. And then turn to your right leg. Bring that left heel closer to your right heel. And put your forehead to as far as you can to your knee or your shin. Feel that stretch in your hamstring. And then step back. Step into forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, round your hands in front. And then back down through heart center. Place your hands to the ground. You can either go back in chaturanga or into downward facing dog, your choice. Inhale, lift your left leg to the sky. Fan open. Back into one-legged downward facing dog. Shift forward, bring your left leg in between your left and right hand. Inhale, crescent. Exhale, warrior one. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, shift forward, reach back, reverse warrior. Tilt your hips forward, engage your core. And then shift, straighten that front leg. Inhale, exhale, reach as far as you can, and then gently go down to your left ankle or to the ground. Open your heart. Be thankful for this beautiful practice, and then gently place your right hand next to your right foot, inside of your left foot, and left hand to the outside of your left foot. Bring that right foot closer to your right heel. Find yourself in triangle, straighten that front leg. Okay, straighten that front leg. And then feel that stretch within your hamstring. And then step into forward fold. Grab your elbows once more. And then swing back and forth. Gently bend your knees, straighten your knees, bend your knees, straighten your knees. And then place your fingertips on the ground and walk out like a penguin. Into Velasana, as far mat width apart, and gently go into Velasana pose, finding your fingertips in heart center. Inhale, exhale, open your heart to the right, elongating your right hand and left hand. You can either stay here, which is awesome, or if you can go a little further, we want to stretch your shoulders. So right here, you have two different variations of Velasana pose. Inhale, back into center. Exhale, to the other side. Either staying here or continuing on with the variation. And then exhale. We're going to slowly roll back into boat pose. Straighten your legs. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, grab your toesies with your pointer finger and your middle finger. And then exhale, straighten your right leg. Inhale to the center. Exhale, straighten your left leg. Inhale to the center. Straighten both legs. Kind of find that balance on your booty. Exhale to the center and go into butterfly pose. Continuing to hold on with your pointer fingers on your big toe. Inhale. And then exhale, forward fold. Alright. Go back into downward facing dog. One more time, inhale, lift your right leg to the sky, and then exhale, bring your right knee right to your right hand, and you're trying to straighten out 90 degree with our front leg into pigeon pose, and trying to shift our hips so that we're even and level with the ground and not one up further than the other. If you are, let's find a block, or even if you're at home, a towel, a blanket. Inhale, exhale,
placing your hands in front, or if you're up here, it's as far as you can go, and that's as far as you're gonna go today. Flex that right foot, inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, up. And then bring our left leg around into pretzel pose. Bring your right hand, right arm to the left side of our outside IT band, our left IT band. Inhale, exhale, hold here for three inhalations and three exhalations. And then gently shift and find your way back into downward facing dog. Lift your left leg to the sky. And then exhale into pigeon pose, continuing to flex that left foot, find that 90 degree line angle with your front two hands. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. So here you have two different variations of the pigeon pose that you can do. You continue to do a flow, or you can find yourself in whatever is best for your hips and your body that day. Inhale, bring your right leg around into pretzel pose. I'm pretty sure it's pretzel, but whatever. Inhale, three exhalations, three inhalations. Find yourself in seated pose where we began. And then we're going to have our hands in heart center, but open them like a lotus. So we're going to receive love from others, even if it doesn't seem like it. Just find the good in everyone, because maybe they're having a bad day, or maybe they need your love. So continue to smile, or if you're not a hugger, then don't hug them. Just, you know, give them a little nod, a little positivity in their life. Because all we want to do in this life is spread love and spread the joy of having the opportunity to be alive on this beautiful